Today, a day of goodbyes as Hartford said farewell to a fallen hero. Firefighter Kevin Bell lost his life in that house fire last Tuesday night. Three other firefighters were hurt.
As Bell was laid to rest, the question still lingers, how did all this happen? News 8's Bob Wilson has the very latest tonight on that investigation and a look at how firefighters from far and near are remembering Bell's life.
Tonight, the investigation does move forward. All day long, the State Police Fire Marshal's Office, they were parked out front with their mobile crime lab. They were going through the house, still collecting evidence, looking for the cause of that fire. Now, they've said they won't release any of the details until the entire investigation is finished, which could be weeks as they try to figure out the cause of the fire and what went wrong inside this multifamily house on Blue Hills Avenue. Meanwhile, just a couple of miles up the road into Bloomfield, firefighter Kevin Bell was laid to rest. Police escorts bring in hundreds of busloads of firefighters as they prepare to bury Kevin Bell, killed in a two-family fire last week. As thousands lined up standing at attention, Bell's coffin floated through a sea of blue to the church. In that blue wall, almost everyone knew a firefighter who lost his life on the job.
You know, when we lost two firefighters this past March, it was very hard on all of us. But, we had great support from Connecticut, the Hartford firefighters.
It's that support, that long blue line that's there for the family, there for Hartford firefighters. Many are strangers and have never met firefighter Bell, but they drove through the night and flew on the red eye to get here and stand in that wall to send a strong message to Connecticut.
When we had our tragedy, one of the ways that you're able to get through such an event is when you have thousands of brother and sister firefighters come and support you.
As a flag-draped coffin on top of Engine 16 drove firefighter Bell to the memorial service and then to the cemetery, it's that same engine that took him to his last call on Earth. And at his side, as they were during the fire, two of the three firefighters injured with Bell. A fourth firefighter still in critical condition at the burn unit at Bridgeport Hospital. It is a reminder of the heavy loss of life and health given to protect others.
It's just the duties that we do. There's so many things that are unknown in our job profession. You get that call and you just don't know what you're getting into when you get to the fire.
And as for the autopsy report, the majority of that has been done, but they're still waiting for some lab results. They say it could be 4, even 6 weeks before they know the exact cause of death. We're in Hartford. Bob Wilson, News 8.
Another firefighter hurt in that same fire that took Bell's life was at that service today. As you heard there, 34-year-old Colin McWeeny still wearing bandages from that fire at the memorial service. McWeeny and fellow firefighter 51-year-old Kevin Burke both treated for injuries and released from the hospital after that fire last week. The third firefighter hurt that night, 29-year-old Jason Martinez, still fighting for his life tonight. He's in critical condition at Bridgeport Hospital. Martinez suffering burns over 10% of his body. We are watching his condition and we'll keep you updated on any changes.
Inside that memorial service today, family and friends remembered Bell as a man dedicated to helping others.
To sing all your praises.
Bell's brother talked about Kevin's other passion, hip-hop music, and all the joy that he brought to others as a DJ. He told the mourners, even from the afterlife, his brother speaking to him.
Stro said, smooth, I'm good, I got this. I dotted my I's, I crossed my T's, I'm moving on to a better heaven. I'm rocking the heavens right now.
During today's service, there was also moving music, songs, and stories about Bell. A fund has been set up to help Bell's family, and you can send your donations to care of Hartford Firefighter Survivors Fund. It's at Farmington Bank. It's 669 Hebron Avenue in Glastonbury. For more information, you can find that on our website at WTNH.com.